MPAMD suspension unrest in presidency as she's ready to spill more. This woman wants to open cans of worm. Oh yes, they underrated her. We've been keeping you up to date recently about this woman. Yesterday came up that she alone took 165 billion. She did not remit it to the federal account, and the matter is on. And listen, this woman is setting presidency on fire as she's ready to spill the beans on those who have been taking money, saying, "I'm not the only one. I will not go down alone." This woman, Hadiza Usman, is not an easy cookie. They thought they would just get away with it, but she's really raising some serious dust, and presidency is not finding it funny at all. Yes, so they are not finding it funny. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up, subscribe if this is your first time. Thank you. NPAMD suspension unrest in presidency as she's ready to spill it all. The suspension of the managing director of the Nigerian Port Authority, Hadiza Balam Usman, is causing raps and serious rips in the presidency, and she's ready to tell it more. The Nation has reported. Hadiza was asked to step aside on Thursday while an administrative panel examined the books of the organization. Although the presidency, which ordered the suspension, gave no reason for its action, sources said it was due to the alleged non-remittance of 165 billion that was supposed to be remitted to the revenue federal account by the suspended MD. So if it's her now, she doesn't go to jail. You see, Nigeria, 165 billion is small money that they should not talk about. Nobody should, they should leave them to play with it, Abi. You see how Nigeria is, and you see those that should be going to prison, answerable to the government and to the people. Nothing is happening. Nobody says anything. They let them go. I mean, they do whatever they like. They go out, they go away with it. No question asked. You see, no question asked. But, you know, but if it's someone else, if it's, yeah, we are, in fact, EFCC has said that anybody that have information on yeah, we Yahoo boys should let them know, because right now they will give the person a million naira for speaking and for saying this person is a Yahoo boy and all that. This is the new thing in Nigeria. These people go scot-free with all the things they are doing. This woman alone, this one you are looking at with this innocent face, only this woman take 165 billion, maybe million or billion, no question asked. But me one person try, you go see her for kirikiri. Let's continue. However, barely 48 hours after the announcement of the suspension, pressure is being piled up on President Muhammadu Buhari by some stakeholders for the appointment of a co-chairman to alternate chairman for the panel, for the pro panel. Some governors who are pleading Hadiza's case with the presidency are said to have accused Transportation Minister Rotimi Amaechi of violating administrative procedure in getting the MD suspended and in composition of the probe panel. The stakeholders are also objecting to the appointment of all members of the panel coming from the Ministry of Transportation. Following agitation for fairness, Transportation Minister Rotimi Amaechi was said to have appointed a 7-man probe panel yesterday, with 3 members from the ministry and the remaining 4 to be none of the head of civil service of the federal government. Besides, supporters of the suspended managing director of MPA have rejected the choice of the agency's executive director of finance and administration, Muhammad Kola, as acting MD. They want Kola dropped and returned to his desk as executive director, because he was nominated by Amaechi. It was learned that Koko was not affected by this shake-up because procurement unit has been relocated to the office of the managing director. Sources said the division in the presidency and the government over the suspension of Hadiza stems from alleged support Hadiza enjoyed from the presidency chief of staff, Professor Ibrahim Gambari, and she is ready to expose more if she's not returned to her position. It was Gambari who wrote a memo to President Muhammadu Buhari for the renewal of the tenure of Adisa as MD of MPA January 21st. It was learned that Gambari acted without any recommendation for renewal from the Transportation Minister or the Supervising Minister of Steel, Senator Bamusi Saraki. A source in government, however, said the Chief of Staff only raised the memo in line with the prerogative of the presidency to make any appointment. One source said appointment and reappointment of any public officer can be done directly by the presidency. An angry Amechi, however, protests to the presidency, alleging that the Chief of Staff was suppressing him and his duty. In retaliation, Amechi took up his memo on the unremitted 165 billion and requested the auditing of MPA to the presidency without routing through its Chief of Staff. Although Gambari later conveyed a letter of suspension of Adisa to Amechi, a source said it was burden he could not resist because it was a presidential order. Despite the crack, Adisa was battling for survival last night with certification that all audits certified supervised were remitted into the CRF unit. Buhari has suspended Adisa through a statement by the senior special assistant of the presidency on media and publicity, Garuba Shehu, who is the new president. The statement said the president also approved the recommendation of the Minister of Transportation for the setting up of the administrative panel of inquiry to investigate the managing director of MPA. It also said the panel is headed by the director, Maritime Service of the ministry, and the deputy director, legal of the same ministry, will serve as secretary. It said all members of the panel will be appointed by the Minister of Transportation. So this is where the problem is. This is where they are fighting themselves now. This is the new fight going on in Nigeria. This is the new one, the new serious problem ongoing now as we speak. You know, it's the North. There is no weather, whatever. It's the North saying, why would they remove one of their own? Why will Adisa be removed? This is all that is happening. You see, Nigeria, unless we begin to tell ourselves about this truth and stop taking all this sentimental and, you know, all these petty things we're doing, I don't think we're going anywhere fast. With the way things are in this country, God will have to help us, you see, because everybody is a boss of his own. We have no president, Garuba Shehu, and the rest of them are the ones that decide, send letter, appoint and reappoint, dismiss and remiss. These are all that they are doing. Leave us a comment. God bless you. Bye for now.